Hello mortals. During a sunny day, take a telescope and look at the sun. Okay, it was a bad idea. Simply look at it with the naked eye. What color is it? Yellow? Orange? Maybe even red, if you live in the samurai land. Let's see what Wikipedia says. But, this does not seem white, does it? That happens because the blue light emitted by the sun is scattered in the Earth's atmosphere. That's also the reason the sky is blue. The remaining light, if combined, will create a yellowish tint. If it were truly yellow, then the snow would look as if a bunch of dogs had urinated all over the place. Here's how the sun looks from space. So by definition, the sun is a G-type white main sequence crocodile. Other than white, like our sun, there are plenty of other colors that stars can have, from red and blue supergiants, yellow, white and brown dwarfs, to black holes. A lot of colors, except green, purple, and pink. Where are all these stars? Pink stars don't exist because the color pink doesn't exist. Watch this video by Minute Physics that explains why. Link in the description. What about green and purple stars? Before this, you need to know that stars shine in more wavelengths of light at the same time. This range of emitted light creates what is called a blackbody curve. No, not this one. Here. As an object gets hotter, the curve goes to the left, corresponding to the shorter wavelength. There is also infrared and superviolet, but humans cannot see it, so it doesn't matter anyways. That is why a super-hot star will be blue, while a dwarf star will usually tend to be red. This is the curve of light emitted by our sun. Now, wait a second. Doesn't our sun peak in green and blue light? Why isn't it green, or blue? You have to remember that other than that, the sun also emits other colors as well. And guess what happens when we combine all of this light together? White. Just as expected. So we have blue super bright stars, and red super dim stars. What about the green? Can't we play with the temperature to get these colors? To achieve that result, the light emitted must peak only in green, without interfering with other colors, and that's pretty much impossible. A star emitting a lot of green light will also emit blue and red light, making it look white. What about purple stars? On the light spectrum, blue and purple light are close to each other, and the human eye will mostly pick up only the blue wavelengths, because reasons. So, on this one it's the evolution who fucked up, not the stars. So next time when you see a green star in the night sky, it's probably just an alien mothership, or you should stop taking shrooms.